because it's been in Chris's family for 90 odd years. We met quite a number of years before we actually bought the garage, yes.
I don't know, I still prefer gallons myself. We were the last business in Warwickshire to sell gallons. When everybody else went to litres, that's why we stopped selling basically. You know, rules and rules. And they said we can't sell a gallon of petrol after a certain date.
Hello, my name's Neil Harrison. We're the developer for the site. We're also the architectural company, so we've designed a new building that's going to go here. So if you're not happy with it in a year's time, I'm going to be responsible, I suppose, but hopefully it's going to be a thing of beauty. But let's talk about this fantastic shed first. I also have a love of old cars, so Chris, the previous owner, we've built quite a nice relationship together, and I'm really happy to say that because it's such a nice historical building, rather than it being scrapped, it's going to be taken down very carefully, and it's going to be rebuilt piece by piece over in Norfolk. But that will include the signs out front, the Wellesbourne sign, Chris's name, the lighting, everything. So I'm very happy to say that it's going to have a new lease of life. I'm thinking it must be nearly 90 years old now, or 90 years plus, so it's great that it's going to keep going.
Yes, he came back from Chile and Peru. He emigrated as an engineer to design railways, the highest railways in the world, in Chile and Peru. Mm-hmm. Then for some reason he came back to Wellesbourne, where his father, again my great-grandfather, he rented these premises, as cottages here at the time. Mm-hmm. He rented them, but my grandfather bought the premises. He built it in, I think, 1923. Mm-hmm. We've got paperwork that shows open in 1924, but we're not quite sure the date. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Then he left, and his wife stayed on running as my grandmother, mm-hmm. With my father, who was here all his life except the war years. His brother, Jack, I think he was here all his life. Early years, Percy, another brother, helped here. Mm-hmm. Dora, the daughter, my dad's sister, mm-hmm. She did paperwork and whatnot as well. Mm-hmm. So very much a family concern.
We met quite a number of years before we actually bought the garage, yes. It's been in Chris's family for 90 odd years. We actually bought it off from Christopher's grandmother. They were going to sell it to some people down south. And Christopher's father took us out one evening and said, it might be a good idea, why don't you two buy it? And sort of horrified us at the time that we thought about it. We'd already bought a house in Stratford, which unfortunately meant we had to sell the house in Stratford because, you know, we needed the finance to buy this. So all those years ago, that's how it happened, basically. It was down to Christopher's father encouraging us to do it. First day here, I didn't even know how to use, how to work the petrol pumps. Bought the place on April the 6th. 1 week later, Christopher's father was, 1978. 1 week later, Christopher's father, unbeknownst, was diagnosed with terminal cancer. He was going to run it for us. And he actually died on the 20th of August, so we had one choice. We'd bought it, sort of really sunk all our savings and everything in to buy it. So it was sink or swim, so we just had to get on with it. So I gave my job up and came here. And 3 years later, Chris gave his up, because he worked in Stratford. And we've run it together ever since, until retiring 3 years ago. We do still get the children who stand, you see the gap in the door on both sides, they stand and peer through. And they're fascinated by it. And they always have been, haven't they? It's always been an open door.
Just out on the footpath here was the first mechanical dispensing pump for about 23 mile radius. I never knew where the next one was, that was always family history. The late years, we moved on to the corner of the building and used to be dispensing paraffin, bulk paraffin. Mm-hmm. And we donated that pump to the Bolton Automotive Museum. About three petrol pumps at that end by the chapel outside, and they went about 12 years ago, would it be? Sort of petrol. Well, again, when the very start of it, the business was more electrical.
Yeah.
When they're putting sort of Austin 7 engines into farmhouses to produce electricity. before there's online electricity. And my Uncle Jack saying that his dad took him out on a motorbike and sidecar, bag of tools, head to some remote farm, left him there to service the engine that turned the generator to make the power for the farm, and sort of picking up 2 hours later and taking him to another one and dotting him around the area, servicing these engines.
So Chris, what are those marks on the wall there?
Oh, the white brickwork and the V roof, that was the toilet block.
Gosh.
It was just a shed about 4 foot wide, open, well, a door that, half a door basically.
Mm-hmm.
You go in and there's a toilet on the left, toilet on the right.
Uh-huh.
Just a pan, a piece of wood across the top with a hole in. And that was the toilets for the cottages that were on here. So we've now got the modern block there instead.
So those are the cottages that came down whenever
the three cottages here built on the back of number 2 school road.
Okay.
They were knocked down to build the garage.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So some of the timber frames in those cottages went on to Big House in Tinton Road.
All right. Yeah.
So I'm not sure which way, somewhere opposite the golf course there. Yeah. They reused the timber frames.
What is that building there?
Well, it was the old telephone exchange. Been extended from the original along, see the crack in the wall, then eventually moved up to Conington Road, the big exchange up there, as the village grew. We use it as a store at the moment.
So it's not full of all the old telecommunications equipment?
No, but there's allegedly a lot of brand new equipment. When they extended, the floor was at a different level, and they just threw brand new telephones, which those times are worth nothing, into the floor and concreted over. I don't know if it's true or not, because somebody else told me they were buried in the garden down here, when there's a hole in the garden. But I'll tell the builder to keep a look at. Again, interestingly, when the cottage took down here, there were cellars. When the garage was first built, they still got the cellars, the holes in the garden. So it was an old Citroen that was scrap, just chucked into the cellar. Again, with the old, the bottles with the gobstopper in the top, things like that. Anything that got in of junk were chucked in the cellar to bring the floor, bring the level of the floor up.
The final days were very emotional. And it will be when the building goes. It's really, I suppose, it hasn't really closed in our minds yet, but certainly hasn't in mine. It's still here, but when the bulldozer comes in, that'll be the worst time, the most emotional time. It's a big part of a life.
Oh, it's a
huge part of a life.
Yes, it really is.
The building over here will remain for a little bit longer, but these two we're hoping will be gone the next 2 or 3 days. Then there will be a slight pause of up to a month, maybe 6 weeks or 2 months before we actually start doing construction. But once we start, we shall continue in earnest. We think it's about a year long, the project. And when we leave, we hope we've left something really lovely in Wellesbourne. And one last thing to add, we are all local people. We either live in Wellesbourne or Barford or Warwick. So we've got to look at this project every day when we come past. And I do hope that I can look at it with pride. Anyway, let me get on, get my hard hat on. Thank you.
3 years ago, when we closed the business, I was more emotional about it then, because of losing the customer contact, the contact with people. I don't feel so bad about it today, but I had quite a few weeks of feeling quite low when we actually closed the business. But we got through it, haven't we? Certainly don't feel so bad about it today, although probably I don't know quite how I'll feel tomorrow. But yes.
So many people were walking past and saying hello. And
it was almost a drop in the centre at times, which was nice.
Yeah.
People felt that they could come in, even if they hadn't got a car or repairs. People could just drop in for a chat.
Which we encouraged.
Sometimes. Shoulders to cry on, weren't we, for various different reasons, yeah. So.